Hey, it's day four. Welcome to Refuel. And on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm about a 50 on how important this is. Let me tell you why. This card, we gave it to everybody at our Southern California Sold Out Thrive Conference. And I told them the story. We had a mom in our church 15 years ago. We actually gave people a card like this. And this mom was heartbroken. Her son had walked away from God. He went to college. He actually came home and announced, I'm an atheist. This mom wisely decided not to overreact. The next week she was in church. She heard this exact message. You can trigger a miracle in the lives. She decided to do that. So she took this card and she put it in her closet and she said, I'm not gonna get on my son's back. I'm gonna take these 5 steps with my son. And I want to be the person that triggers a miracle in his faith and changes the course of his life. And she started by raising her expectations and seeing him in terms of what he could become. And then she anticipated obstacles. She went, this may not be easy, but I am not going to let obstacles cloud me and lower my expectations. Third was this increased contact. She went, I'm just going to positively stay connected to my son. I'm going to enjoy, he's going to be attracted to my faith because of how I relate to him. And number four is a really big deal. It is start serving. Start serving. These four guys in Mark chapter 2, the entire passage is them serving. They actually go get the guy. They pick him up, that's serving. They carry him, that's serving. When they try to get in and the crowd stops them, they didn't quit, that's serving. They go up on the roof, that's serving. They dig a hole in the roof, that's serving. What does it mean to serve? It means they take this person, they work hard, they don't quit, and they just kept lifting this person up, and eventually God worked in their lives. That's what it means to start serving. Now, one quick thing about the whole area of serving. Most people shy away from serving because I'm too tired. I actually believe this, the least happy people on the planet are the people that aren't serving. I can prove it. When's the last time you met a self-absorbed, self-centered, happy person? They don't exist. I'll give you another example of that. Once a year, our church shuts down to serve the community. We're actually doing that in September. We shut down to serve the community, and then after that whole thing, Sunday night, we have a gathering at the church. We have dinner and sort of a celebration of worship. And the first time we ever did this, I arrived on Sunday night, and I thought, these people have been serving all weekend long. They've been out in the hot sun. They've been serving. We had 160 projects all over the community. And I thought, they're gonna be dead. Nobody's gonna show up. I walked in, the room was packed on Sunday night after a weekend of exhausted serving. We walked in, Lincoln Brewster walked out and the worship band started up and the roof flew off the joint. There was more energy in the building than I have ever seen in any service before or since. And I went, man, there is something about the process of serving that actually recharges your spiritual batteries, fills your heart with joy, and your passion level goes sky high. Serving is a really big deal. So much that this year, our staff, we took 6 months and we rewrote all of our core values. And my favorite of all of our core values is this one, which we unleashed at the conference. If you're taking notes, this is another leadership tip. You can drift or decide. You never drift anywhere good. Matter of fact, even a dead fish drifts downstream. And I realize as a staff, our culture needed some help. And so we actually rewrote what we are as a staff. Bayside's culture and values. This is the 62nd run at this. Our whole staff worked on it together. We wanted, and our whole theme is this. If you're on our staff, we have 3 themes. Here are the, we want you to live well, love well, and lead well. We want you to live better because you're on our staff. We want you to love your family better and want your kids to love you more because you're on our staff. We also want you to lead well. And so we take a month a year in our staff meetings. A month is live well, a month is love well, and a month is lead well. We bring in people from all over the country to help our staff on this kind of stuff. But we wrote core values. Our number one core value is this: health is more important than growth. Okay? Our second core value is this: we will lead by integrity. And we actually have this phrase, if you live with integrity, nothing else matters. And if you don't live with integrity, nothing else is gonna matter. Okay? And the one I wanted to read you this, because this is the serving one. And you know what our value is? Here it is. Go right out of this fact. We dig holes in roofs. You wanna hear it? Here we go. Just like the friends and the paralyzed man dug a hole in a roof to get their friend to Jesus, we will go to great lengths to get people in front of Jesus. Why? Jesus believed everyone was worth it. Worth the work, worth the cost, worth the chaos, worth laying his life down for. Why do we have 35 Christmas Eve services? We're digging a hole in a roof. Why do we have 49 breakaway kids camps this summer? We're digging a hole in a roof. Why do we drop 50,000 Easter eggs from a helicopter? We're digging a hole in a roof. Why do we have a light show in a parking lot last year? As a matter of fact, do we have a picture of that? And a next picture? And a next picture? That's our church parking lot. We turned it into the number one attractor for parents and kids to drive through in the entire Sacramento region. Over 90,000 cars went through last year. It was the single highest number of unchurched non-Christians to ever drive on a church campus in history, okay? It was awesome. Matter of fact, our high school ministry, we had to stage them. Our high school ministry figured out that, whoa, we can make some money off this. So our high school ministry went to every car and sold them stuff as they were coming through to fund all our stuff. Why do we have a light show? Why do we take second offerings in our services to rescue girls? Why are we doing that? Because we are digging a hole in a roof. Why do we have the stage, the lights, the music, the weekend culture? We are digging a hole. We are helping people see Jesus who might not see him any other way. Lack of creativity is usually just a lack of effort. We are called to be fishers of people. Let's stay committed to putting more hooks in the water. This is a huge deal. Too many churches are content with they've stopped being fishers of men and they've started being keepers of the aquarium, and God has better days ahead than that, okay?